There is a formula that can help you create stunning logos in Midjourney. Welcome back, and if you're new here, my name's Sana, and on this channel, we talk about AI tools and how to use them. And today, we're talking about my go-to formula for creating great logo design within Midjourney. Actually, you can use this for any image generation tool. I'll be using my favorite, Midjourney. Here's a sneak peek of some of the results that I've gotten using this formula. Now, the prompt formula itself is really simple, but applying it can really help you elevate your designs. By the end of this video, you'll be able to apply this formula to create better, interesting, and beautiful logos within Midjourney. I'll walk you through the process step by step, showing you how you can use this simple approach to elevate your designs that next level. Stick around till the end and I'll show you some sample prompts and the results I've gotten using those. Let's roll. All right, let's get into the good stuff, the formula. Whether you're using Midjourney or any other image generation tool, there are five key elements that you want to include when prompting for logo design. This formula works because these elements work together to create a logo that's not just visually appealing, but also perfectly aligned with your brand vision. The five elements include the type of logo, the subject, the artistic genre or movement, inspiration from any famous designers, and then of course, you don't want to forget to specify what you don't want in your logo. Including each of these elements in your prompt will give you really great results. Now, you can get a logo design if you don't include these elements, but including all of these five will give you a really great result. All right, so the first thing you want to do is have a good understanding of the type of logo that you want. Are you going for a word mark, a pictorial, a mascot, an emblem, abstract? Choosing the right type of logo sets the foundation for everything else. If you don't know the different types of logos, don't sweat it. In my research, I came across this link that is really great because not only does it list out the different types, it gives you visuals on what these different types look like, but also it tells you the advantages and disadvantages of using each type of logo. This will really help you strategize what works best for your brand. Knowing the different types and what they look like is really useful because it gives you the language to be able to prompt Midjourney to get the type of result that you're looking for. For example, if you want a mascot logo, you need to specify to Midjourney that that's what you're looking for. I'll continue going through the different elements, and then at the end, we can put this all together and look at the different types. Next in line in the formula is the subject. Now, what do I mean by subject? The subject is your focal point. It's the primary visual element in the logo. Now, this can be anything from a human character, like an astronaut, or wildlife, like leaf for growth, or a lion for strength, or an eagle for freedom, or even a mythical creature like a phoenix for transformation. Your subject can also be an object like a coffee mug for a coffee shop, or an ice cream cone for an ice cream shop. It can even be an abstract symbol or even just stylized text. Really, it's that focal point, that main character of that logo. Just remember that if you're prompting for text in Midjourney, you want to add that in quotation marks. This way, Midjourney will recognize this as a text, and the probability of that showing up as text significantly increases. It's not always consistent, but it does work. Just, you might have to give it a few tries. The subject is essentially that core component, that core element within your logo design. In Midjourney, the more specific you are, the better your results will be. Generally, you would have the subject towards the beginning of the prompt so that Midjourney places a higher emphasis on this part of the prompt. Mentioning the art style in your prompt will guide Midjourney to the vision that you're trying to create. Let me show you a couple of different styles so you can see the impact that the art style has on the prompt. I'll use the same seed number so we get similar results. Drawing inspiration from famous designers is what's really helped me create great logos within Midjourney. This nifty addition of adding inspiration from different designers, whether they're logo designers or not, actually has helped me get some really stunning results. If you find a logo designer whose work you really like, you can add their name within the prompt to guide Midjourney to create similar results. Midjourney will then follow the designer's style and aesthetic. If you're searching for famous designers, here's a website that lists a few of them. I'll leave a link in the description below. Take a look at the same logo with inspiration from different designers. This prompt includes Milton Glaser, who is a famous designer responsible for the logo for Mad Men and I Love New York. This prompt takes inspiration from Lyndon Leader, who created the logo for FedEx, Pizza Hut, and Taco Bell. And of course, Paul Rand, who is a famous designer who created the logos for IBM and UPS. Adding the name of the logo designer helps give Midjourney more of a creative direction, ensuring that it reflects the quality and the styles of that designer. This can lead to a more effective logo, one that's tailored to your vision. All right, this part is crucial and one that many people miss. Of course, you want to tell Midjourney what to include, but you also want to tell it what to exclude. What are some things that you don't want to include in your logo? You need to specify those for Midjourney. Use the dash dash no command to exclude anything you don't want in the logo. You can specify that you don't want it to be photorealistic or that you don't want any shading. It's a really crucial element in your formula that ensures that you get exactly what you're looking for. Finally, I want to mention iteration because you might not get that perfect logo on the first try. Be prepared to run multiple prompts, tweak them, and refine them as you go. Each iteration will get you closer to that perfect logo. All right, let's try this formula out and see the results we get. And there you go, that's my formula for creating amazing logos within Midjourney. Again, one that you can use in any image generation tool. I hope you found this video helpful and I hope you try out these tips. Let me know how it goes in the comments below. Don't leave just yet, I've got some more examples coming up, so stick around and check them out. I'll see you in the next video.